But by now you know how to add log sheets and also how to use the dashboard. What we're going to show you in this video is how you can add log entries manually. Now you might want to use this feature when you're adding a log entry, you know, log entries for the past 14 days for historical, so you've got that in there and the app will calculate correctly. Or you could just use this to add your log entries as your normal way of doing it rather than through the dashboard. So what we're going to do, we've got two log sheets there. We're going to look at Sunday the 4th and add some log entries to this log sheet. When you go to click on the log sheet, it brings up a list of log entries. As you can see there, there's no log entries currently for Sunday the 4th of December. To add a log entry, you simply tap on the plus on the top right hand side. Now I must point out before this that when you're adding log entries, you only add your work time, not your rest time. The app will calculate your rest time for you automatically. You don't need to add rests into the app. The only time that this is not the case is when you're driving two up, and in that case you need to add your non-stationary rest time. Not your stationary rest times, but your non-stationary, as this helps the app calculate whether your rest is a non-stationary or a stationary rest time. So we're just going to tap on the plus on the top right. We put in our start time, so we're going to put it in for 9:30 a.m. Hit OK. Now we're putting our end time, so we'll set that for 12:30 a.m. That's all the app needs in order to calculate correctly. It doesn't need anything more. You can see there, you can add an alarm on the left there if you want to, so that the app will remind you when your rest break is coming up or when you want to stop driving. You can also put in your odometer start. The town you started from. These are optional entries, but not bad to put in, so you've got a record of them. You can see it brings up common towns when you're adding the log entries. There's a GPS icon here too, where you can, it will just show you the towns closest to where you currently are, just by tapping on that. Obviously you have to allow the app to use your GPS, and then it will bring up that list. Now you can see the actual kilometers per hour is only 15, which is interesting. So we can see here we went from 9:30 to 12:30 a.m. So we want to change that to PM. Now you can see it's 76 kilometers an hour. The last thing you can enter here is your registration. So that came up with the last registration, but we're going to change trucks in this case. Once you've got all the entries in, all that information, you can now hit plus and it adds that. Now say we drove from 1:15, so we had a 45 minute break until 1. We're going to see how long we can drive for in this case. So we'll put in 1:15 p.m. as our start time. Notice here you can actually tap to calculate your drive time. It will tell you when you need to stop next. In this case, it's allowing me to drive for 6 hours. I can then just put in my where I ended up and the town that I ended up in. Still got the same track, but there's also here a track list which you can click on, and it brings up all the tracks that you've added so far. As you add new tracks in your log entries, it automatically adds it in the list there, so that you keep a record of that and you can just swap between them and don't have to type them all in. Save that entry, you can see that's saved there. It says I've driven from 9:30 to 12:30, then I had a 45-minute rest break and drove from 1:15 to 7:15. I can click on the work diary and it will draw that for me, as you see there, just as you would on a driver work diary, showing you how you fill it in. You can pinch to make it bigger or smaller. Click on the log entries brings you back to the log entry screen. You can also toggle between go back and forth between your log sheets. If there was more log sheets entered, you could just keep going back and back. So this was the 4th of December, that's the one we added those entries for. You can also email a work diary or print a work diary if you've got your printer set up. Email a range of work diary sheets. So we'll just click that again. Hopefully you've privileged access to that. So it goes back 14 days, but you can go up to 28 days. You can have it sign the pages if you have your signature in the app. You can send a export of entries in a CSV file. So if your compliance team would like that in a CSV file, you can send that. You can send statistics that will show you when your compliance team, when your next 24-hour break is due, how many hours you've used for the day, the week, or the fortnight. So all that information, they can help with their scheduling. And you can also show breaches if you have any breaches in the app. And if I hit that, it will now bring up the screen, choose my email program, and I can send that. I won't do that in this case. We'll just go back into the app. So that's basically how you add log entries into the app. I hope that has shown you how to use that feature so that it's very easy to use from now on. Thanks.